You're watching KSG State Series. In this video, we are going to talk about the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and the Union Territory of Ladakh. We begin with a brief introduction. Capital of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir is Srinagar. Capital of Union Territory of Ladakh is Leh. They both share their borders with Punjab and Himachal Pradesh. International border is shared with Pakistan, China, and Afghanistan. Talking about the political divisions of Jammu and Kashmir, well, this Union Territory has three divisions. The Gilgit-Baltistan and POK region, it has been under Pakistan control since 1947. Aksai Chin region, this has been under China after 1962 Indo-China War. And the Jammu-Kashmir Valley and Ladakh region, this is under India. Speaking of the geographical features, mountain ranges from north to south are Karakoram Range, Ladakh Range, Zanskar Range, and the Pir Panjal. Jammu and Kashmir is home to several valleys such as the Kashmir Valley, Tawi Valley, Chenab Valley, Poonch Valley, Sindh Valley, and Lidder Valley. The Himalayas divide the Kashmir Valley from Ladakh, while the Pir Panjal Range, which encloses the valley from the west and the south, separates it from the Great Plains of northern India. Now, how is the vegetation in these two Union Territories? Well, the northwestern thorn scrub forests and Himalayan subtropical pine forests are found in the low elevations of the far southwest. These give way to a broad band of western Himalayan broadleaf forests running from northwest to southeast across the Kashmir Valley. Rising into the mountains, the broadleaf forests grade into western Himalayan subalpine conifer forests. Above tree line are found northwestern Himalayan alpine shrub and meadows. Much of the northeast of the state is covered by the Karakoram to West Tibetan Plateau alpine steppe. Around the highest elevations, there is no vegetation, simply rock and ice. And now let us tell you about the rivers in these Union Territories. Jhelum, the river Jhelum is commonly known as the Veth. The source of this famous river is Beri Nag Spring in the district of Anantnag. In the valley of Kashmir, this river has a length of about 203 kilometers. After passing through Srinagar, it flows into the Bular Lake, which is regarded as its delta, and then passing through Baramulla and Uri, it flows to Pakistan. The Jhelum River is the only major Himalayan river which flows through the Kashmir Valley. The Indus River originates at the confluence of the Sindh River and the Gar River, which is Mansarovar Lake in Tibet. It is the longest river in the subcontinent. While it is about 3,500 kilometers long, 1,500 kilometers of it flows through Jammu and Kashmir. The river banks are flanked by steep hills that have pine and deodar vegetation. The Indus River flows in between the Ladakh Range and the Zanskar Range. Indus has several tributaries. Principal among them are Gilgit River, Gumal River, and Kabul River. The third river is Chenab. Merging of two Himalayan rivers forms the river Chenab. These are the Chandra River and the Bhaga River. Thus, the river Chenab is popularly known as the Chandra Bhaga. This river enters Jammu and Kashmir near Paddar at Kishtwar. The river Wadwan joins it near Akhnoor. It enters the plains of Jammu and then enters into Pakistan. Kishanganga. This river is in Dras, that is in Kargil, in the inner Himalayas. After passing through the mountain tracks of Gurez, Kiran, and Karna, it joins the Jhelum at Doimal. Kishan Ganga hydroelectric project is situated on this river. Tavi. The source of Tavi is the Kailash Kund spring at Soej Hills in Bhaderwa. After flowing through the Chenani and Udhampur, Tavi passes through Jammu and joins the Chenab in Ranbir Singh Pora and then enters Pakistan. Lastly, the river Ravi. Ravi, known as Iravati to ancient Indians, originates from the northern face of Rohtang Pass. The major multi-purpose project built on this river is Ranjit Sagar Dam at Thane village. Now let us tell you about the climate and weather. The climate of Jammu and Kashmir varies greatly owing to its rugged topography. Across from the Pir Panjal range, the South Asian monsoon is no longer a factor and most precipitation falls in the spring from southwest cloud bands. Because of its closeness to the Arabian Sea, Srinagar receives as much as 25 inches of rain from this source, with the wettest months being March to May with around 85 millimeters per month. Across from the main Himalayan range, even the southwest cloud bands break up and the climate of Ladakh and Zanskar is extremely dry and cold. Annual precipitation is only around 100 millimeters per year and humidity is very low. This region, almost all above 3000 meters above the sea level, and winters are extremely cold. In Zanskar, the average January temperature is minus 20 degrees Celsius with extremes as low as minus 40 degrees Celsius. All the rivers freeze over and locals actually do river crossings during this period because their high levels from glacier melt in summer inhibits crossing. In summer in Ladakh and Zanskar, days are typically a warm 20 degrees Celsius, but with the low humidity and thin air, nights can still be cold. Now let us tell you about the types of forests. The main forest types found in Jammu and Kashmir are subtropical dry deciduous forests. These forests are generally found in the lower reaches of Shivaliks in Jammu. The common tree species are Acacia catechu and Dalbergia sisu. Subtropical pine forests. These forests are situated in upper Shivalik and outer Himalayas. The common species found here are Pinus roxburghii, Albizia and Dalbergia. Himalayan moist temperate forests. This type is found in Chenab Valley. The common tree species are Cedrus deodar, Pinus wallachiana and Quercus, etc. Himalayan dry temperate forests. This type includes the main forests of Kashmir Valley with the common tree species as Cedrus deodar, Pinus wallachiana and Picea smithiana. Alpine forest. These forests are situated above the main temperate zone. Common species found in this zone are high-level fir and kale, junipers, rhododendron and a variety of wildflowers and grasses. Forest in cold arid zone. Leh and Kargil districts fall in this zone where natural forests are meager. Juniperus exists sporadically. Plantations of poplar and salix developed by the forest department over a period of time need irrigation. Robinia has been introduced in the recent past. And now let us tell you about the passes in these union territories. First up is Zojila. Zojila Pass is situated at an altitude of 11,578 feet on Srinagar to Kargil to Leh National Highway. Government of India approved the construction of Asia's largest bi-directional Zojila Pass tunnel, which will reduce the travel time through Zojila Pass to 15 minutes from the current 3.5 hours. Other passes are Changla, Khardungla. Now this is 18,380 feet highest motorable road in the world. Shingola and Banihal Pass are the others. Talking about the mountain peaks, Nanga Parbat is 8,126 meters, K2 is 8,611 meters, Broad 8,047 meters, Gajar Broom 1 is 8,068 meters and the Golden Throne is 7,193 meters. Speaking of the lakes here, Dal Lake, it is the second largest lake in Jammu and Kashmir. Pangong So, 60% of it is in Tibet. So Moriri, Wular Lake, 60% of the total fish production in the state comes from Wular Lake, Manasbal Lake, and the Sheshnag Lake. Now, the Sheshnag Lake is an oligotrophic lake, that is a water body that has a low content of algal production and thus has clear water of high drinking quality. It is home to several species of fish, including the brown trout. The lake appears greenish in color because of its lush green meadows that surrounds it, making it a breathtaking beauty to admire. Sheshnag Lake is mainly fed by the streams and snow mountains above it, and it usually freezes in winter. Talking about the Ramsar wetlands, Surinsar Mansar Lakes, it is an oligotrophic lake, over 1.5 kilometer long and also 1 kilometer wide. Mansar Lake is revered by locals for its mythological connection to the sacred Mansarovar Lake in Tibet. Hokarsar, the 13.75 square kilometer Hokarsar is the largest of Kashmir's 9 wetlands and hosts approximately 7 lakh birds every year, the biggest share of these winter visitors to the valley. From last 3 decades, Hokarsar wetland was reduced to less than half its size. Wular Lake. This is one of the largest freshwater lakes in Asia and the largest flood basin of Kashmir in the northern Bandipora district. The lake controls the flow of the Jhelum River, which traverses it. Wular Lake is a major habitat for the exotic avian life of the region. Somoriri, one of the highest lakes in the world, the largest of the high-altitude lakes in the Trans-Himalayan Biogeographic Region. It is entirely within India, designated as a Ramsar site because of its unique wetland. That's not all about this picturesque lake in the elevated district of Rupso. And now let us tell you about the national parks located in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. Dachigam National Park is in Srinagar. The name literally stands for 10 villages. The park is best known as the home of the Hangul or the Kashmir stag. Hemis National Park is in Ladakh. It is famous for snow leopard, Asiatic ibex, Argali or the great Tibetan sheep. Kishtwar National Park is in Kishtwar. The park is famous for Himalayan snowcock and the brown bear. Salim Ali National Park is located in Srinagar. And the Kazi Nag National Park is in Baramulla. This national park is famous for Markhor and Himalayan musk deer. The wildlife sanctuaries are Changthang in Ladakh, Karakoram, Lachipora, Overa Aru, Gulmarg, Hirpora, Surinsar, and Limbar. And now let us tell you about the minerals found in these union territories. Limestone, all districts of Valley, Kathua, Udhampur, Rajouri, Poonch, Kargil, and Leh has limestone. Gypsum is found in Baramulla, Kathua, Ramban, and Doda district. Marble, it is found in Kupwara, Kargil, and Leh. Coal in Udhampur and Rajouri. Magnesite in Udhampur. Borax in Puga Valley in Leh. And graphite in Baramulla. Time to tell you about the economy of these union territories. We start with agriculture. Over 65% of the population of more than 1 crore depends on agriculture and allied sectors. Agriculture and allied sectors contribute 27% of state income. State faces massive deficit in food, that is 40%, oil seeds, that is 70%, and vegetables, that is 30%. Only 42% area is under irrigation. Around 90% of available groundwater is unutilized. Over 70% of net sown area is under food crops. A little over 13% is under fruits. Productivity level of all agricultural crops is lower than national averages. The main kharif crops of the state are rice, maize, pulses, vegetables, and fodder, covering 78% of the NSA. Jammu is home to high-quality basmati and rajma. Kashmir is home to high-quality saffron, zira, fresh and dried temperate fruits, and commercial floriculture. Kashmiri saffron is very famous and brings the state a handsome amount of foreign exchange. Ladakh is home to high-quality apricots and sea buckthorn berry. Baramulla is the leading apple-growing district. Karawas is an intermountain valley fill comprising of unconsolidated gravel and mud. A succession of plateaus is present above the plains of Jhelum and its tributaries. These plateau-like terraces are called karawas. Its fertile soil is good for saffron cultivation. There are several power projects in these union territories. Baglihar Stage 1 Hydroelectric Project is on the River Chenab. Chutak Hydroelectric Project on Suru. Uri 1 Hydroelectric Project on Jhelum. Nimmo Basgo Hydroelectric Project on Indus. And the Ranjit Sagar Dam Hydroelectric Project on the River Ravi. Now, if you talk about these two union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, and if we do not talk about Pashmina wool, then this video will be incomplete. India produces the finest Pashmina or cashmere wool in the world, the main and the best quality coming from the Changthang Plateau of Ladakh. Pashmina wool is produced by Changra goat or the Pashmina goat in Ladakh and Chegu breed of goat in the eastern parts of Himalayas. Let's tell you about the various crafts of all of these regions. Jammu is known for Basholi painting, calico painting, and Phulkari. Kashmir is known for carpets, Kashmiri shawls, wood carving, paper mache, chain stitch, truwel, and namda. Ladakh is known for wood carving and painting, clay molding, Ladakh Pashmina weaving, Ladakh carpet, Thanka and Presha painting. And now let's tell you about the culture of these union territories. Rauf, Dhumal and Geetru are the famous dances. Bahumela, Shikara festival, Gurez festival, Saffron festival and Jiri Mela are the important fair and festivals. Temples located here are Raghunath temple, Sudh Mahadev, Amarnath shrine, Khir Bhavani temple and Vaishno Devi Mandir on the Trikuta hills. Talking about the monasteries, Samstanling and the Hemis monastery. Now Hemis monastery is the biggest monastery of Ladakh. Bhand Pathar is Kashmir's traditional folk theatre. The major ethnic groups living in Jammu and Kashmir include Kashmiris, Gujjars or Bakarwals, Paharis, Dogras and Ladakhis. Institutions located in these union territories are High Altitude Research Laboratory in Kashmir's Gulmarg and the Central Institute of Temperate Horticulture in Kashmir's Srinagar. And now let us tell you some interesting and important facts about these two union territories. In the Rajatarangini, a history of Kashmir written by Kalhana in the mid-12th century, it is stated that the valley of Kashmir was formerly a lake. Siachen Glacier is 70 km long, making it the longest Himalayan glacier. Ranbir Canal has the largest irrigation network of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The Marthand Canal is one of the oldest canals of Jammu and Kashmir, believed to have been constructed from 600 to 900 AD. It has derived its name Marthand Canal from the Marthand temples. Kashmir is known for the sports goods. Wood from Kashmir is used to make high-quality cricket bats known as Kashmir willow. Basholi is famous worldwide for the Basholi painting. Shanti Stoop is a white-colored dome-shaped structure located in Chandspa, which looks extremely beautiful during night when illuminated. This peace pillar was built by a peace sect of Japanese Buddhist organization to celebrate the completion of 2500 years of Buddhism and for the promotion of world peace. It was inaugurated by His Holiness the Dalai Lama in 1985. The pillar is known for its gilt panels depicting the life stories of Lord Buddha. Asia's largest tulip garden is in Srinagar. Pir Panjal Railway Tunnel is India's longest railway tunnel. China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or the CPEC, passes through Gilgit-Baltistan region of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, to which India has objection. That is one of the major hindrances in India joining OBOR. Ladakh, also known as Little Tibet, is renowned for its remote mountain beauty and Buddhist culture. Coal Desert, cultural landscape of India, is situated in the Himalayas and stretches from Ladakh in the north to Kinnaur, Himachal Pradesh in the south. The shikaras are traditional small wooden boats. The houseboats are a common feature in lakes and rivers across the valley. Now finally, let us tell you about the Indus Water Treaty. The Indus Waters Treaty was signed on 19th of September 1960 by then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru and Pakistan's President Ayub Khan. It was brokered by the World Bank. According to the treaty, Bias, Ravi and Satluj are to be governed by India, while Indus, Chenab and Jhelum are to be taken care of by Pakistan. That's it in this edition of KSG State Series. Hope you liked this video. Stay tuned to our channel for more such informative videos on the various states and union territories of India.